Hi, I welcome you all for this session. In our last session, we learnt MRP in brief. MRP is nothing but material requirement planning. We know what are the inputs and outputs of MRP. The major inputs are bill of materials, master production schedule, and inventory. We will see what are these inputs are used for MRP. Master production schedule has its own inputs, which is in turn required forecast and work orders, and bill of materials and inventory. These are the inputs for MRP. MRP plays a major role for a particular organization to bring into a correct picture. In master production schedule, we have two inputs, as we know that sales orders and a forecast. What do you mean by sales order? Consider a company. A company is manufacturing a car. Car consists of different assemblies and sub-assemblies. A customer service team will be there to bring the orders for a particular company. There will be n number of customers, and the customer service team will bring the orders into a system of our particular organization, and there will be some delivery date required for that. There will be customer demand date for that particular models. There will be n number of models in the car, so there will be n number of orders for n number of quantities of n number of models. We are producing n number of models in a particular company based on the orders what we receive from the customers. Customers will acknowledge the orders. Our system will acknowledge the orders when it is required to deliver. And forecast is one of the other inputs to the MRP system, in turn into the master production schedule. Forecast plays a major role, because once we update the forecast, which will be input for MRP. Let's see what are the forecast that we will see one of the examples. Our example, we assume that we have five major customers. We have quantity of cars to be produced or to be sold to a particular customers as wish. For customer A, 2.5K. For B, 12,658. For customer C, 8,659. There will be some forecast values, but we will concentrate in this video only on a particular component, wheel, which is a part of a car. We will see what is the bill of materials for a wheel. A wheel consists of tire, rim, hub, spoke, and wall. A quantity per indicates for preparation of one assembly of wheel, how much quantity is required. You can see here. For our core cast, I estimated around 60,000 cars to be produced, because keeping a 2,000 spare considering manufacturing losses. The components are tire, rim, hub, spoke, and wall. Quantity per we already decided, and the quantity required for one wheel will be 60,000 tire, rim, hub, wall, and spoke, as it is 25 per wheel. For one car, we consist of 4 tires. It is multiplied by 4. MRP consider the finished goods stock and raw materials available on the hand for deciding the quantity to be ordered. As you can see in our video, components, quantity per, on-hand quantity, quantity required as per forecast, and the quantity MRP will order. MRP, as I told you, it will take the on-hand stock of finished goods as well. Assume that you don't have any stock. We have only raw materials. These are the raw materials we have on-hand quantity. As per forecast, we are short by quantity MRP will order. For that quantity MRP will order, so that we are short by that quantity. For example, tire, you can take. Bill of materials. What are the inputs? As we know that there are three major inputs: bill of materials, master production schedule, and inventory. What you can donate or for using bill of materials, we will give the input what to order. Master production schedule will give you when to order. Inventory will specify you quantity of order. Similarly, for output, if you see, we have four outputs of MRP major: purchase order, material plan, work orders, and report. Purchase order is nothing but order quantity that MRP generates. Now we will consider how MRP software will work. If you require assembly of a car in the fourth week of the month, consider in the month end. So you have sub-assembly, we are telling about wheel assembly. For wheels to get assembled into a car, it needs one week lead time. And then wheels required should be by third week of the month. And the raw materials which are required for the wheels should be within the production place by second week of the month. And therefore, the supplier has to dispatch a particular raw materials which is required for wheels to be assembled in the first week. That is depend upon lead time. For different products, there are different companies, there will be different supplier lead times as well as manufacturing lead time. We should provide the input to the MRP system regarding the lead time of different raw material issues, regarding production, as well as time for assembly, lead time for supplier. This is how the MRP system works. In this video, we learned brief about how MRP system will work from end to end. This is how MRP system works. If you like this video, like, share, and subscribe for further tutorials on supply chain management. I am Vijaya, who created this video. Thank you for watching.